Everybody, let's get an update on your Friday afternoon forecast. Heading into the lunch hour, temperatures right now sitting at 82 degrees in Greenville. A bit of a west wind coming in at 10 miles per hour. Feels like 85 when you factor in the humidity. Feels decent for a day in the middle of August, that's for sure. Temperatures low 80s out there. Haven't warmed up a lot just yet, but I expect us to probably reach 90 degrees in many places across the upstate later today. In western North Carolina, still haven't quite reached 80 degrees yet. Some spots a little cloudier than others. That's part of the reason we haven't warmed up so much as of yet. You can definitely see where the clouds are in the visible satellite picture. A lot more sunshine, though, farther east towards Spartanburg and Gaffney. Watching a little batch of showers across Tennessee right now. That was from storms that were forming earlier this morning over towards Arkansas and Missouri. There is still a possibility that we run into some brief light showers this afternoon, and a pretty good chance tonight that we see some possible heavier downpours that move in associated with that system there. Excessive heat warning still in effect for Arkansas and Louisiana. They are just really simmering in the heat over in the western half of the South. It's a firm reminder that summer's not over yet, number one. And number two, it could be hotter this time of year. 85 for that feels like temperatures, really, really not bad for middle of August. Okay, so yeah, it's going to be a little hot, but not crazy hot like it is farther west today. Temperatures topping out around 90 to 91, depending on where you are. There's the future radar painting that chance for some possible brief heavy downpours initially in western North Carolina. It won't be until later this evening that that chance moves farther south into the upstate. By 8 p.m., still really only the northern half of the area that has that chance of rain. Farther south, not so much. 9, 10, 11 o'clock rolls around, and then we get some more rain coverage that starts to move in. Could be, again, pretty heavy in western North Carolina and possible very brief heavy downpours really late tonight in the upstate. Pretty scattered coverage, but not expecting any form of severe weather with this. Maybe just a quick rumble of thunder, and that should be about it. Drying out into sunrise Saturday morning, then Saturday afternoon, essentially more of the same. Starting off with pretty nice, lots of sunshine for the first half of the day. Maybe some occasional brief pop-up showers or storms, but this is classic summer weather where you have a quick shower or storm, nothing really widespread or extreme expected. Just be a little bit hotter. Temperatures getting up closer to 92 to 93 in most places, with again a possibility of some occasional downpours. So here are the rain chances for the next few days at around 40% for this evening and the afternoon and evening for Saturday, dropping to 20%, mainly dry Sunday and Monday, and then basically nothing for Tuesday as some drier air moves in. For the mountains, slightly higher, of course, 50%. These next 2 days, then down to 30 Sunday and Monday, and Tuesday we also dry back out in earnest. All right, so let's talk Ernesto real quick. Another quick update for you. As of the 11 o'clock advisory, still a Category 2 hurricane, winds up to 100 miles per hour. Coming up on Bermuda, that's it right there, and it should be passing really close to the island. They'll be seeing some pretty big impacts from the storm as it's Category 1 or 2. It's still going to bring tons of storm surge and strong winds to Bermuda, but luckily it's still expected to jet off into the North Atlantic over the next into the start of next week over the weekend. So not really a problem for the Carolinas unless you're headed to the beach trying to enjoy the surf. You're probably not going to be able to because of the rip current risk down there. I believe they've got red flags flying today, so be mindful of that. If you're headed down to the beach this weekend, higher than usual rip current risk down there. So here's what I've got for the 4 day. Again, occasional pop-up showers or storms tonight, and then for part of the afternoon and evening tomorrow. Mainly dry for Sunday and for Monday. It's going to be hot-ish this weekend with highs in the low 90s, but again, we get cooler temperatures early next week by a few degrees, 87 Monday, and then 85 to 86 Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. As some drier air comes in, it will be slightly more comfortable outside. Same for the 4 day plus for the mountains, occasional showers or storms over the weekend, nothing crazy, and then cooler next week. High of around 80 Monday and Tuesday, and only in the upper 70s Wednesday and Thursday.